brings us toward the end of a nearly century-long struggle to reform America's healthcare system. Ever since Teddy Roosevelt first called for reform in 1912, seven presidents, Democrats and Republicans alike, have taken up the cause of reform. Time and time again, such efforts have been blocked by special interest lobbyists who perpetuated a status quo that works better for the insurance industry and the American people. With passage of reform bills in both the House and the Senate, we are now finding a way to deliver on promise of real, meaningful health insurance reform. The reform bill that passed the Senate this morning, like the House bill, includes the toughest measures ever taken to hold the insurance industry accountable. Insurance companies will no longer be able to deny you coverage on the basis of pre-existing conditions. They will no longer be able to drop your coverage when you get sick. No longer will you have to pay unlimited amounts out of your own pocket for the treatments you need. You'll be able to appeal unfair decisions by insurance companies to an independent authority. This legislation becomes law. Workers won't have to worry about losing coverage if they lose or change jobs. Families will save on their premiums. Businesses that would see their costs rise if we do not act will save money now, and they will save money in the future. This bill will strengthen Medicare and extend the life of the program. It will make coverage affordable for over 30 million Americans who do not have it. 30 million Americans. Because it is paid for and curbs the waste and inefficiency in our healthcare system, this bill will help to reduce our deficit by as much as $1.3 trillion in the coming decades, making it the largest deficit reduction plan in over a decade. As I've said before, these are not small reforms. These are big reforms. In the past, this will be the most important piece of social legislation since the Social Security Act passed in the 1930s. The most important reform of our healthcare system since Medicare passed in the 1960s. What makes it so important is not just its cost savings or its deficit reduction. It's the impact reform will have on Americans who no longer have to go without a checkup or prescriptions they need because they can't afford them, on families who no longer have to worry that a single illness will send them into financial ruin, and on businesses that will no longer face exorbitant insurance rates that hamper their competitiveness. The difference reform will make in the lives of the American people. I want to commend Senator Harry Reid, extraordinary work that he did, Speaker Pelosi, for her extraordinary leadership and dedication. Having passed the reform bills in both the House and the Senate, we now have to take up the last and most important step, reach an agreement on a final reform bill that I can sign into law. I look forward to working with members Congress and both chambers over the coming weeks to do exactly that. With today's vote, we are now incredibly close to making health insurance reform a reality in this country. Our challenge then is to finish the job. We can't do another generation of Americans to soaring costs, eroding coverage, and exploding deficits. Instead, we need to do what we were sent here to do, improve the lives of the people we serve. For the sake of our citizens, our economy, and our future, make 2010 the year we finally reform health care in the United States. Everybody, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Do you have a holiday wish for the troops? I do, and I will be actually, I'm on my way right now to call a few of them and wish them Merry Christmas and to thank them for their extraordinary service as they're posted in Iraq and Afghanistan.